Hello everyone. Our lesson for today is The Fun They Had by Isaac Asimov. So how would our life be if teachers are being replaced by robotic teachers? Just think and see. How will our life be when you go to a hotel and in the hotel when the chef is being replaced by a robotic chef? How will it be? How will your life be when your pet animals in future are being replaced by robotic pets? How will it be? How will it be if the matches that are being played by players, human players, are being replaced by robotic players? How would it be? How will our life be? Just imagine and see. So before we move into our lesson, let's take a quick view of our author, Isaac Asimov. He was born on Jan 2, 1920. He was an American writer and he was a professor of biochemistry at Boston University. He was known for his work of science fiction and popular science. Sir Isaac Asimov was a prolific writer. He has written and he has edited more than 500 books and an estimated 90,000 letters and postcards. He was considered to be one of the best science fiction writers during his lifetime. Now this lesson, The Fun They Had, tells us about how the schools in future would be, how learning takes place through computers, how classrooms would become virtual classrooms, how human teachers are being replaced by robotic teachers, how books are being replaced by e-text. This is what the lesson tells us about. Now let's just see the main characters of this lesson. Margie, 11-year-old girl, she hates reading and she shows interest in knowing about the past schools from the real book. Next, Tommy. Tommy is Margie's cousin, 2 years elder to Margie, and he finds a real book and he likes reading books. Mrs. Jones, who is Margie's mother, and we see about the mechanical teacher or the robotic teacher who teaches Margie and Tommy. He teaches different subjects and the robotic teacher or the mechanical teacher works on the television screen. So now let's get started with our lesson. Margie even wrote about it that night in her diary. On the page headed 17 May 2157, she wrote, "Today, Tommy found a real book. It was a very old book. Margie's grandfather once said that when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when all stories were printed on paper. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly, and it was awfully funny to read words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on a screen, you know. And then when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had when they read it the first time." So here we see Margie as the main character of the story, and she is a girl who is 11 years of age. And she writes a diary on the night of 17 May 2157. At that time, Margie writes an entry in her diary and she writes that Tommy had found a real book and she is feeling so strange because in her times, real books did not exist. They only have e-books and virtual books. So books in the format of print on paper are somewhat extinct, and Margie is astonished to see a real book. Margie is reminded of her grandfather. He told her that his grandfather studied all the books that were printed on paper. So this kind of a book is historical or ancient for them, something which they cannot believe, they can't imagine. Margie is talking about the book that Tommy had found. She says that the pages of the book had turned yellow and they had been crushed as it was very old. The children found it very funny to read the words which stood still. On the other hand, the books that Margie and Tommy read were online books. So in the e-books, how it happens, the text keeps on moving as your screen keeps moving. It was a different experience when you read the printed matter. This was a very strange experience for these children. When you have a book which is printed on paper, whenever you flip the pages for you to get, you see the same thing written on the pages. On the other hand, in an e-book, the text keeps changing on the screen. The screen is the same. You have the same screen in front of you, but the text keeps changing again and again. So whenever you go back, the text is different. Gee, said Tommy. What a waste. When you are through with the book, you just throw it away, I guess. Our television screen must have had a million books on it, and it's good for plenty more. I wouldn't throw it away. Same with mine, said Margie. She was 11 and hadn't seen as many telebooks as Tommy had. He was 13, she said. Where did you find it? In my house, he pointed, without looking because he was busy reading in the attic. What is it about? School. So, in this passage we see, Tommy disliked the printed books. He said that it was a waste because he felt that whenever you complete reading a book, you have to throw it away. So that's what we normally do. Once we finish reading a book, we just dispose it. You cannot have some different story written on the same book. On the contrary, he felt that the computer screen was very good, because the same screen had shown him many books and still he could read many more on it. He would not have to throw the screen away once he had read a particular story. Margie agreed with Tommy's opinion. Margie was 11 years of age and she has not read as many books as Tommy had, because Tommy was older to Margie. He was 13 years of age. And Margie asked Tommy that where had he found the printed book. And Tommy replied to Margie that he found the printer book in the storeroom of his house. He was so busy reading the book that he did not remove his glance from the book. Margie asked what the book was about. And Tommy replied that the book was about school, about going to school, about the life at school. So let's get started with the next passage. Margie was scornful. School? What's that right about school? I hate school. Margie always hated school, but now she hated it more than ever. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography, and she had been doing worse and worse, until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully and sent for the county inspector. So in this passage, we read that Margie hated the word school, and so she said that what was there to write about it, and an entire book had been written about school. What is Margie's school? Margie's school is just mechanical teacher. What do you mean by a mechanical teacher? A teacher who teaches you, and a machine that is going to teach, not a human. And you will no school, and just a room in the house would be your classroom. Now, why did Margie hate school? Margie's school was a virtual classroom. It was not a real school like we have today. In future, we are thinking that the schools will be virtual classrooms. There will be machines that will be teaching the children. Margie hated the machine because it was giving her so many tests in geography, which were very difficult for her, and she was performing very bad. And finally, a mother thought that there was something wrong with the machine, and so she had to call the county inspector to check on it. Passage 4. He was a round little man with a red face and a whole box of tools with dials and wires. He smiled at Margie and gave her an apple, then took the teacher apart. Margie had opted. He wouldn't know how to put it together again, but he knew how all right. And after an hour or so, there it was again, large and black and ugly, with a big screen on which all the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. That wasn't so bad. The part Margie hated most was a slot where she had to put homework and test papers. She always had to write them out in a punch code. They made her learn when she was 6 years old, and the mechanical teacher calculated the marks in no time. So in this passage we see that the county inspector has come to check the mechanical teacher here, and they are describing how the county inspector was. He was round like a man, a round little man with a red face, and he was carrying a big box full of tools, dials and wires. So when the man opened the machine, he was there to repair the computer. And then he opened up the computer, and Martin wished that he would be unable to close it back because she did not like the computer. She did not like to study from this teacher. But the man was an expert, and within an hour he had repaired the computer and had closed it and made it ready to teach Margie once again. Margie gives a description of the computer. She feels like it was very huge. It is black in color and she dislikes its appearance. It has a big screen and all the lessons appear on the screen, and many questions are asked on the same screen, which was too difficult for this little girl. Margie hated the mechanical teacher. The most hated person was a mechanical teacher, and she did not submit her homework and test papers to it. Margie had to write her homework and all the test papers in a particular punch code and in a computing language. She had learned the language at the age of 6, and the machine checked the papers and calculated the marks in a few seconds. The inspector had smiled after he was finished and patted Margie's head. He said to her mother, "It's not the little girl's fault, Mrs. Jones. I think the geography sector was geared a little too quick. Those things happen sometimes. I've slowed it up to an average 10-year level. Actually, the overall pattern of her progress is quite satisfactory." And he patted Margie's head again. Margie was disappointed, and she had been hoping they would take the teacher away altogether. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month because the history sector had blanked out completely. So she said to Tommy, "Why would anyone write about school?" So what have we seen in this passage? The county inspector said that Margie was getting very bad marks in geography because the machine was not working properly. It was geared to a higher level. He And you also said that sometimes machines malfunctioned and that is what had happened. He had slowed it down and set it to a pace of a learner of 10 years of age. He said that Margie was learning at a good pace. He again patted Margie's head in order to cheer her up. Margie was sad because she did not want to learn. She did want to study from the mission. And she wanted that inspector to take it away. Margie is reminded of the time when Thomas' mechanical teacher was taken away for repair for almost a month and he was enjoying his time as he didn't have any teacher. It had been taken away because the history sector portion of the machine that taught the history subject had been wiped out. So the mechanical teacher did not have any memory of it and had to be taken away for repair. Now we know the reason for Margie's dislike for school. So she asked Tommy that why would anyone write about school? Passage 6. Tommy looked at her with very superior eyes because it's not our kind of school. Stupid. This is the old kind of school that they had hundreds and hundreds of years ago. He added loftily, pronouncing the word carefully, centuries ago. Margie was hurt. Well, I don't know what kind of school they had all the time ago. She read the book over his shoulder for a while, then said, anyway, they had a teacher. Sure, they had a teacher, but it wasn't a regular teacher. It was a man. A man? How could a man be a teacher? Well, he just told the boys and girls things and gave them homework and asked them questions. So what did you understand from this passage? Tommy was looking at Margie with the superior eyes because he knew something that Margie was not aware of. He said that Margie was silly because she did not know that many years ago the school was not the kind they had. And Tommy wanted to stress on the time period and said that centuries ago. What do you mean by century? 100 years together makes one century. And Margie was hurt at Tommy's behavior and she said that she did not want that kind of a school that was there centuries ago. And she was curious and imagined a group of children being taught by a human teacher. She looked over Tommy's shoulder, trying to read the book, and said that perhaps they had a teacher. Tommy is referring to a machine teacher as a regular teacher because that is what they are used to. Margie could not believe that a man was a teacher because she had always seen a machine doing that. Tommy tells that the man who taught the class discussed many things with the students, gave them homework and then asked them different questions based on it just like their mechanical teacher did. Passage 7. A man isn't smart enough. Sure he is. My father knows as much as my teacher. He knows almost as much I better. Margie wasn't prepared to dispute that. She said, I wouldn't want a strange man in my house to teach me. Tommy screamed with laughter. You don't know much, Margie. The teacher didn't live in the house. They had a special building and all the kids went there. And all the kids learned the same thing? Sure, if they were the same age. So here in this passage we come across that, we see, Margie said that a man teacher is not as intelligent as a machine teacher. So now Tommy asked Margie not to underestimate the human teacher. He said that he has a knowledgeable as a machine. He compares the machine to his father and says that his father knows as much as the machine teacher is aware of. Tori could be better than her human teacher knew as much as a mechanical teacher did. Marty did not want to discuss this further and added that she did not want a strange man, the human teacher, to come to her house to teach her. Tori found it very funny when Margie said that she did not want a strange man to come to her house to teach her. He said that teachers didn't come to the students' house to teach them. They had a special building called a school and the students went to the school to study. Margie was astonished and asked that all the children learned the same thing. And Tori said that all the children of the same age studied the same thing. Passage 8. But my mother says a teacher has to be adjusted to fit the mind of each boy and girl it teaches, and that each kid has to be taught differently. Just the same they didn't do it that way then. If you don't like it, you don't have to read the book. I didn't say I didn't like it, Margie said quickly. She wanted to read about those funny schools. They weren't even half finished when Margie's mother called. Margie, school. Margie looked up. Not yet, Mama. Now? Said Mrs. Jones. And it's probably time for Tommy too, Margie said to Tommy. Can I read the book some more with you after school? So in this passage we see Margie refers to a machine teacher and she says that her mother told her that the machine had to be tuned to the level of each boy or girl who was studying from it. So each child had to be taught separately depending on their level. Tommy replied that in the past he did not do in such a way. He got irritated at Margie and said that she need not read the book again. Margie was interested in the book as she was curious to know what kind of a school was there in the past. Margie was very inquisitive. She wanted to know what kind of schools were there and how the students had been learning. Margie had just half of the book when her mother called and she said that it was time to attend a virtual school. Margie's school was in the next room, next to her bedroom. She said to her mother that not yet, and she did not want to go to school. Margie's mother said to Tommy that it was time for him to go to school too. Margie was so interested in reading the book that she asked Tommy if she could read the book with him after school. Passage 9. Maybe, he said, nonchalantly. He walked away whistling the dusty old book tucked beneath his arm. Margie went into the schoolroom. It was right next to her bedroom and the mechanical teacher was on and waiting for her. It was always on at the same time every day except Saturday and Sunday because her mother said little girls learn better if they learned at regular hours. The screen was lit up and it said, today's arithmetic lesson is on the addition of proper fractions. Please insert yesterday's homework in the proper slot. So here, Tommy tried to ignore her and said that maybe she could read it. Tommy was feeling very great because Margie was interested in reading the book. He placed the book under his arm and he went off to his school. Margie reached her school. It was a room next to her bedroom. It was a virtual classroom and the machine teacher for Margie was there and she was waiting for the classes to begin. Margie studied all days except Saturday and Sunday at the same time from his mechanical teacher. Margie's mother was very particular and she told Margie that she would learn better if she would study every day at the same time. Margie sat in front of the machine, similar to a computer, and the machine was turned on. It said that the lesson of the day was in arithmetic and the topic was addition of proper fractions. Further, it also instructed her to insert the homework of the previous day in the slot for inserting the homework. Passage 10. Marky did so with a sigh. She was thinking about the old schools they had when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy. All the kids from the whole neighborhood came laughing and shouting in the schoolyard, sitting together in the schoolroom, going home together at the end of the day. They loved the same things, so they could help one another with the homework and talk about it. And the teacher were people. The mechanical teacher was flashing on the screen when we add fractions 1 by 2 and 1 by 4. Marty was thinking about how the kids must have loved it in the old days. She was thinking about the fun they had. Here Marty's life is also very mechanical, just like a machine. There is no fun in a classroom and it is very dull and boring, just like a machine. Marty is thinking of the story told by her grandfather. Her grandfather told her that his grandfather used to go to school when he was a little boy. As Marky is bored with this machine, she is reminded of that life. This is the life that you all are living at present. But for the future kids, it will be just a memory of the past. For them, it will be history because their life will be very different. They will study from machines. When Marky comes to know that in the past children used to go to school, they sat together, laughed and shouted in the school. She gets curious about it and wants to go to school. The writer wants us to realize the importance of schools in our life. Children sometimes get bored and fed up of going to school. But if you don't have a school, you won't get to meet friends. Your life will be very dull and it will be very boring. Marky feels that school is so much fun. Children get together, they study in a fun way and they also get the same homework and they can discuss about it. They can get help from each other and also talk about it. So all the students become friends and they study in a fun way. She found it very strange that the teachers were not machines, but they were human beings. Thus, the author ends the story with a beautiful title of the chapter, The Fun They Had. The fun the students had when they went to real schools. Marky is just thinking about the kids of the past who went to school and enjoyed studies. Thank you.